Decision made. Okay, we can't all be like Cher from Clueless when it comes to picking out the perfect outfit, but wouldn't that be nice? We are making it a little easier for you to look your most fashionable this fall with the hottest trends, especially the colors this season. Allison Goodman from the Scottsdale Quarter is here with some lovely looking models with what we should be adding to our closet. Even if it's still triple digits, it's time for us to transition into fall, right?
Definitely, at least with color. You can easily wear some darker colors.
Yes.
Fall is my favorite season for shopping, honestly, and there's so much good stuff right now that I can't take it.
So, okay, we didn't go too crazy. Let's bring in our first model.
Yes.
Because I noticed that we've got a lot of the same tones.
Yes.
Showing up again and again with
earth
their selections.
Tones for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a maroon jumper. It's actually a really fine corduroy.
Nice.
And corduroy is everywhere this season. We paired it with a t-shirt because it is still a little bit hot. So
right.
This is a really great transition outfit.
So it's so 70s, right?
Yes. The 70s and the 90s are back in a big way.
You say that like you're so excited. I love that about you, Allison. I feel like she's writing that down in her journal. 70s are back.
In a big
90s
way.
90s are back in a big way.
And this is all from Planet Blue.
So in theory, if you were living in another part of the country, you'd put it on with a sweater.
Yes.
Or, okay.
I would even do like a turtleneck or a
yes.
collared shirt underneath it, a pair of tights and booties. You can really wear this now and into the winter.
Very cute. Looking good. Thank you. That's a beautiful color, I think, on every skin tone,
too. I love
too.
It. Yes.
Well, everything looks good with that red hair.
I know. I love this outfit, too. So this is all from H&M. Browns are everywhere this
yes.
season. That's another little nod to the 70s.
Okay.
I love all the different tones. It's a faux suede skirt. And with a blouse like this, a silk blouse, it's really great for work.
Wow. And it's nice to get those more trendy pieces, of course, at someplace
yes.
like an H&M or Forever 21, so you don't have to invest so much.
Definitely.
But the different textures make it so interesting.
Yes, I think so, too. And I really, again, love that brown tone. It can really be matched with a lot of different colors.
Beautiful. Very nice. Speaking of textures,
yes.
check out these pants.
This is one of my favorite looks. This is all from Joie. I love a high-waisted pants.
Mm-hmm.
I love that paperback waist. It's really flattering. Moody florals are really great for fall, and so this is kind of a nod to that. It's a little bit of a darker palette,
wow.
a little bit of a darker color
wow.
tone, and then paired with the leather pants, it kind of makes it a little edgy.
Those pants are amazing.
Yes, I know. I love them. I love the waist. That's my favorite part.
It takes some confidence. Do you think shorties like us could wear those
pants?
I think
so. I would want to wear them.
You do. I love it. Looks great on you. Very nice. Thank you. Okay, so animal prints
yes.
always circles back.
Definitely.
I think it's one of the rules, never throw it out, right?
I agree. And
okay.
it can be a neutral in a lot of time,
yeah.
you know, a lot of places. This is a really great outfit from Intermix.
I love
the mixture
mm-hmm.
of the sweater with the silk shirt. And you have like a little bit of leopard print if you don't want to go all out. But there's tons of great options too in terms of skirts and sweaters. I really love this look. And the flare jeans are, they're everywhere now.
Oh my gosh. Okay, so this is one piece, right?
One piece, yes.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, it's a really lightweight piece too. So it actually, even though it looks a little heavier,
yeah.
it's really great for transition.
That's a good transition. And then the kind of higher in the front, lower
yes,
in the back?
Definitely.
Wow, very cute.
You can do like a little front tuck. If you don't want a front tuck,
mm-hmm.
it already has that illusion.
And that can be dressy or casual.
Definitely.
So the high-waisted flared jean
yes.
is something that I'm not all of us have in the closet right now.
Right.
We were transitioning for many years of the skinny jean.
Yes.
At least one pair you should get for the fall.
I think so. And
okay.
definitely wear them with a pair of heels. You
okay.
really want to elongate the leg. When
mm-hmm.
you are a little bit shorter, you want to make sure that your leg looks as long as possible.
Those look great. I love it.
I love them too.
So updated. Thank you. Speaking of long legs, she doesn't have to shorten anything. It's automatically short. Here we go. Ooh, I like that pant a lot.
Last but not least, this is all from Forever 21. I love the mixture of the plaid. We kind of kept it a little bit into the winter with the
mm-hmm.
sweater over it. A silk blouse is just an easy staple piece. You can pair it with anything. But I really love this legging.
Oh, that is so great. And this is a good reminder. I mean, this looks very expensive to
right.
me. But it's obviously
so
not.
Yeah, Forever 21 is one
mm-hmm.
of the greatest pieces. You can get some really great staples and the trendy pieces as well.
Very nice. Ladies, come on out. You all look amazing, and it's all reasonable to wear even though we're still a little hot, because we do want to transition. We're
yes.
over the summer.
And there's air conditioning everywhere,
you're
so
right.
you'll be fine.
Well, if you go around our newsroom, every lady is wearing a gigantic sweater at their desk because of the AC. So these looks are perfect. I was anticipating the big plaids.
Yes.
You left those behind.
I know. Unfortunately,
those are at the stores too.
So they're actually a lot more smaller plaids than I anticipated, but the big plaids, like, I think as we get into winter, we'll really start seeing
okay.
those patterns.
ladies, thank you so much. All of these fashions from the Scottsdale Quarter. Allison, thank you so much. Great selections. April, are you ready to do some shopping?
Always. What I'm really ready for, though, are some fall temperatures, so it'll feel a little more like fall around here. So the next couple of days, we're headed in the other direction. We're actually going to warm it up from where we've been for the first half of this work week. In fact, your Friday probably going to be our warmest day of all this week. We have storm chances that are very slim across the state. If we see anything, it will be very isolated in far eastern Arizona. The rest of the state going to stay quiet, but not for long because we now have Rosa. This is now a hurricane this morning. About this time yesterday morning, it developed into a tropical storm, and this morning it strengthened. And the desert southwest, including Arizona, really going to be on guard for this storm because it looks like one that's going to push a lot of moisture toward Arizona potentially early next week. So here's where Rosa is this morning. And again, it's a Cat 1 storm right now, which means it's got 75 mile an hour sustained winds. It's pushing toward the west, northwest at about 10 miles an hour. It's forecast to continue moving in that direction. And then watch what happens. It kind of curves around here.